Two spheres, one with radius 7 and one with radius 7 and one with, let me do this again, one and one with radius 4 are tangent to each other. If P is any point on one sphere and Q is any point on the other sphere, what is the maximum possible length of PQ? So let's think about this. So let me draw the sphere with radius 7, and obviously a sphere is a three-dimensional object. I'm going to try to draw it in two dimensions. So a circle you could kind of view as a cross-section of it. So this right over here, cross-section at its widest point of the sphere. So it has radius 7. So it has radius 7. And it is tangent to another sphere that has radius 4. So it has radius 4. So the other one might look something like this. Once again, it's a cross-section. It's tangent at exactly this point. And I've just drawn circles, but this, you can imagine this, these are actually spheres. So I'll try to give it some actual depth so that you recognize that these are not just, you can imagine balloons or balls of this shape. Now, P is any point on one sphere and Q is any point on the other sphere. And we want the maximum length of PQ. So we want to get these points P and Q as far away as possible from each other. So if I was just dealing with two circles, I'd stick P right over here, all the way here, and I would stick Q all the way over there on the other circle. And so the distance between them is going to be essentially the sum of the two diameters. So it's going to be 14 plus 8, and 14 plus 8 is going to be equal to 22. And so if I could do that with two circles of these radii, I could obviously do these as spheres as well. You can imagine these are the cross sections of those spheres. So I can get to a distance of 22, but am I sure that that's the furthest distance? Well, you could reason through it that, look, if you were to try to bring P out a little bit more onto the surface here, on the surface, yeah, there's going to be a little bit of distance now that it's kind of going out of the page, if you're going out of the surface right here, but it's getting closer, essentially, along the page. So maybe those two things trade off, or maybe this really is the maximum distance. And if you're taking this on a standardized test, this could become a very involved thought process that you start saying, well, how do I prove that this is absolutely the furthest distance? But many times the test itself is designed so that you don't have to prove it. Because notice, we can definitely find a distance of 22. This we can definitely find between two points on these two surfaces. And notice, that is the largest of all of their possible choices. So we would go with the largest of all of their possible choices. This would be a little bit more confusing. You would have to be a little bit more rigorous with yourself and say, well, you know, do I really know that if they had a choice that said 23 or a choice that said 22 times the square root of, you know, of 2 or something like that. But the fact that you can definitely get these points to be 22 away from each other, and that is the largest of all of the choices, that's a pretty good clue that that is the maximum possible length of PQ. In a future video, I could do a more in-depth proof that this is actually going to be the case.